Hello friends, very good morning, very good afternoon. In this session, we are going to see different types of data and how it is useful for SQL and NoSQL and how to structure it. So let's see different types of data. So first of all, structured data, then second is the semi-structured data, and third one is the unstructured data. Structured data, it means there is a the data is stored in a tabular format. Each row and column contributing to a specific row and column. As structured data is schema dependent, and it is a little difficult to scale the large database. So it is also known as the schema dependent data. So we can see here is the table. Student is the table. Student having the column like ID, name, city. Means there is a fixed structure. Means they are lying in a particular one tabular structure format. And suppose there is a student table, then there is another department table. So they are connected to each other and form a RDBMS system, relational database management system. So this nothing but the structured data example. And we can say there is a numeric text, then there is a date, then there is a binary or a bit. So different types of data we can save, but there is a structured the fix. So this is the nothing but the structured data. Then second thing is the semi-structured data. Semi-structured data, it means the data that lies in between, middle between the structured data and unstructured data. And example of semi-structured data like XML, CSV, JSON, and it is complex than the structured data and less complex than the unstructured data. Means, so let's say there is a text, take the example of the XML file, then JSON file, then CSV file. These are the example of the semi-structured data. Means there is a structure with having their column, like let's say how to design this file in XML format. So student is the node, then there is a ID 1 node close tag close, then there is a name Rahul, name close, then there is a third one is the city Pune, close tag, and here student tag we have to close. So this information is about one row, correct? So same like we can create for the second, third. So this information is stored in the student.xml file, correct? Student.xml file, and that file we can store in the database as well, no problem. So such a like of data we can call it as a structured data. And third thing is the unstructured data. Unstructured data, it means like there is a video file, audio file, then image, or there is a different files like Word file, PDF file. These are the files, different files types, correct? And image, you know, audio, you know, MP3, WAV, then there is a JPG, then there is a PNG, and video, MP4, MPEG. These are nothing but the file format of the JPG. So this data is known as the unstructured data. And unstructured data means actually it is best fit, means there is a it is also known as the schema independent data. How? Yeah, we can see. First of all, you know, structured, semi-structured and unstructured. So we will see what are the different things are come into the scenario. First thing, there is a we are saving the data in a table. At that time, here is the image. I have to save the image of each student. Then what I will do? I will add one column here. Means there is a you can store your miss particular student image. Then there is Kiran image, Manish image. One thing here. Suppose here is the image in a binary format 100001. So that image we can store, no problem. But there is a certain limit for the database or table, and let's say that table size is the 4 GB, and what will happen? Then there is a, it will impact on the hard disk, and there is a 4 TB. If we are storing multiple millions of record student in the particular student table, then what happen? Then ultimately hard disk will affect. And what is the actually performance? Means suppose I have to retrieve the data for Kiran student, then it will scan the record and it will retrieve the data, or it will retrieve the photo from that particular hard disk and that particular hard disk location, and we are getting that data, no problem. But performance is matter when there is a large number of records in the table. So performance hamper, then there is a, if we require, then there is a RAM required, hard disk required. So these are nothing but the hardware, correct? And we have to add the capacity, hardware capacity. Suppose there is a, in future there is a 8 TB data, then ultimately we have to add the RAM, we have to add the memory, we have to add the hard disks on that machine. So it is the vertical growth of the particular table. Independently it will affect the database, database will affect the hard disks. So that come into the performance factor, and it is the horizontal vertical growth. And how to resolve this issue? We can resolve this issue with the help of horizontal scaling of the database. Means let's say horizontal scaling, it means there is a, we can there is a type of system in which, first of all, here is the distributed database. Distributed database, it means there is a multiple nodes in it. Means we can say there is a node having the hard disk, then there is a RAM, then there is a CPU, correct? So for each computer, this, for each node, this having the that particular hardware. So in this system, this we can apply the processing power. With the help of that, we can add the hard disks, and data is horizontally growth. Means let's say if we have to add n number of nodes, we can add. So that problem is solved. And one more thing, performance is boost. So that's why a distributed database come into the picture. And what is the example of it? There is a, I think you already know about the, you heard about the Hadoop. Yeah, and that system uses the HDFS, means Hadoop distributed file system. Data is stored in a multiple disk, and you can gather it, and there is a MapReduce or a YARN. With the help of that, we can retrieve that data. So we will, in the upcoming session, we will see that. But right now, only just keep in your mind, there is a, what is HDFS, means Hadoop distributed file system, and which database is having, there is a edge base. So this is the distributed database system. To horizontally growth, or there is a performance factor, or there is a large number of data, means there is a, if you heard about the big data. So big data is nothing but the large amount of data we have to handle. Then there are certain factors on it, means there is a V, means different variety of data. Then there is a velocity of data, then variety of data. So these come into the picture, and we will see in upcoming session. I will take a one separate session on Hadoop and HBase. So we will consider right now only thing about how distributed search stream come into the picture. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like it, share it, and please subscribe my channel. Thanks. Bye bye.